All right, so for this, we did the first integral. So all we have left is tangent squared antiderivative. So let's do tangent squared x dx separate. I'll do that right over here. All right, what are some ideas? How can we integrate tangent squared? And remember, you have calculus tools, you also have algebra tools. So let's talk about calculus tools. Well, do you know the derivative, antiderivative of tangent squared off the top of your head? No. So I think a u sub's probably not gonna work because derivative is gonna have some secant stuff, which I don't see. So u sub's probably not gonna be good. Integration by parts, I don't think it's going to work too well. So derivative of tangent squared is going to be 2 times tangent times secant tangent. So that's going to get worse, not better. So I don't think our calculus tools are going to work. So what algebra?
Sine over cosine squared.
So I like that. We could write sine over cosine squared. We can rewrite tangent. That's one option. If I had a cubed power, this would work out pretty well. I could do that same kind of trick that I did before where we'd have one of them extra and then turn the other ones into sine squared minus one or cos squared minus one. So that the fact that these are both even, that won't work. So what's another algebra move I can make aside from writing in sines and cosines? What other identity do you know that has tangent squared in it? So I could write 1 over cotangent squared, but I'm not sure that's going to change around too much.
Is that like 1 minus secant squared?
So there's a tangent squared plus 1 equals secant squared. So let's use that, and we'll just solve for tangent squared. It may be on the board already. Well, I'll just rewrite it. So we got tan squared plus 1 equals secant squared. So tan squared is 1 minus secant squared. This is way better. I know the antiderivative of secant squared. Maybe you do too.
Isn't it secant squared minus 1?
Oh, secant squared is, wait. Yeah, it is. Should be secant squared minus 1. Absolutely. All right, so the antiderivative of secant squared is what? Regular tangent. So this is a nice antiderivative, and antiderivative of x is, of 1 is x. So we got tan x minus 1. So ready to drop that in over in our original problem on the left. Yeah, so we took the antiderivative there.
Oh, okay.
And then this was my last, that wasn't my last antiderivative. So on the next step, antiderivative of u squared, u cubed over 3 minus tan x plus x. And now my last antiderivative I just went through. So now it's plus c. And then of course we have to unsubstitute u. So that's tan cubed x over 3 minus tan x plus c. So a lot of the problems in this section are a little bit extra difficult because there's not a very straightforward way to explain how to do them. We're going to do one more problem out of this section. And this will probably be another difficult question. So we're going to look at the antiderivative of secant cubed x dx. What are some ideas for this? Yep, so we could break off, basically kind of use the idea that we had at the beginning where there was odd power, so you're going to separate out the even ones with one left over. So let's write down some facts that we know. So I have that Pythagorean identity fresh in my mind, so let's write that guy down. Tan squared x plus 1 equals secant squared x. And I'll write down as many calculus things as I can remember. So I'm going to write the derivative secant equals secant tangent.